Trnava, day 3 of the F5J World Championship. Even more clouds. Today we are covered by a thick altostratus clouds, and sun has only now started to peek through it. It's cold, windy, as you can probably hear. We have even more wind than yesterday. And flying now is very difficult. No thermal soaring to say, so to say, just dynamic soaring from the waves generated by the wind on the obstacles on the field. This is now fourth or fifth group of the day, and still everyone is starting far into the wind. Oh, another hit on the start. I think that guy has a damaged aileron. Let's see if I can zoom on him. He's returning, I believe. There's something hanging off his wing, off his left wing. Looks like a propeller from the other plane cut through it. Controllable, and he'll land safely. Okay, he'll get a refly. So what I wanted to say is that at least now majority of the planes go to the north side of the field. Looks like they learned from yesterday evening experience that this tree line here is generating enough waves that you can catch and gain some minutes of flight time from them. So I've seen a couple of planes this morning gain a surprising good height in that part of the sky. Looks like no one is doing it at the moment. They're all just hanging there and waiting for something to pass by, if it will pass by. So the wind forecast for today is 7 meters per second on average, with gusting up to 13. So I need to check the weather station there at the ready box, what that shows, since that's the official wind speed for the competition. And if that goes over 10, I guess the jury will have to pause the flying. What's happening here without any proper background for reference. It's all uniform gray. So it could be planes going up or down, or my hand is shaking. You can't really tell. So here is some horizon for the reference. and you see that the planes are just hanging there. Going down slowly. Like no one caught a wave this time, so maybe we'll see some dynamic soaring on the trees down there. People opted to land. There's one more, two more getting ready to land, and this is the last plane in the air, I believe. At least on this part of the sky. Not sure if there's anyone behind me, but I think not. Planes flying more like a spear than a plane. This is because they're all ballasted to the max, usually twice the normal weight, and of course this affects the flying characteristics a lot. I guess this was the last plane to land. Time is about 6 minutes. No, there's one more actually. Oh, the trees. I have missed that one somehow. Where he was from the start. It looks like he's aiming for the full time. With 2 minutes to go. Looks like he can make it. Lost a lot. One more pass over the trees. Maybe 10-20 seconds more. One minute to go. impressive slope soaring there. Seconds to go, very nice. So we are seeing launches to over 300 meters here in this kind of weather, which really doesn't make sense. I mean, if you go to 220 meters, that's already minus 1 minute of your flying time. And if you go to 300 meters, that's minus 5 minutes, and then you make a 4-minute flight, you end up with zero score. Nonsense. Better to go to 200 meters and do a 4-minute flight. At least you get some score. So, next group after the previous one, we are observing a proper dynamic soaring. Behind the tree line, this guy is doing it now for a couple of minutes already. And looks like a winning strategy, because you can do this from like 30-40 meters start height, and you can do this for 10 minutes at the lowest height, and the best score of the day of the flight. Not sure how the F5J plane must be balanced to be able to fly like this, but apparently it can be done. He now has to go for a landing, but trust me, it was quite a show. I'm not sure who that was, but anyway, congratulations. It's now around 2 p.m. and around 9, group 5, I think, is getting ready to start. While in the distance, some people are still retrieving their planes from far down the field. We had a period of sun, which caused the wind speed to increase. I checked the official weather station, it said 9.8 meters per second gusts, and I'm sure there were some of them even stronger, but that's still below the upper limit. So we are flying. I've seen some impressive climbs downwind to very high heights. We've seen a dynamic soaring over the trees, and let's see what this group will now do. So planes are going all over the place, spreading now out nicely. I've seen someone doing an engine run on inverted, not sure why. But the planes are now two to my right, most of them slightly left and upwind. And then there is one that went downwind already. Bravely circling, not sure if he has good air or just because to get further downwind. So wind is not blowing exactly down the runway anymore. It's blowing slightly from the north. So if you look up the runway, it's blowing from the right. Which means it's blowing over the airport infrastructure and over those trees there. So looks like now majority of the planes joined that guy. And there's a bit of a crowd here. They're doing nothing while there's one more who is circling and he's a bit further out, and then there are a few more joining him now. So looks like they think it's a good order. They're reluctant to really allow their planes to be blown far downwind, so they do a few turns and then come back into the wind for the next patch of good air and do a few turns more and so on. So you can only allow yourself to be blown downwind once you are in a really good thermal, because you need enough height to come back. And if you are in a good thermal, it often happens that coming back means flying through a really good sink as well. Struggling over there. He's behind the trees and quite low. Clock says 5 minutes to go, and doing 5 minutes from this height requires more than just some luck, also lots of skill. landing already. And from where I'm standing, I don't see that plane anymore. People walking down the field, so could be that he decided to land behind the trees. Other guys in the meantime, there's four or five people quite high. This one is the lowest of them. More above my head approximately, and with 2 minutes to go I think they will all make this flight. I try to be overhead at 1 minute mark and then fly 30 seconds downwind, do the turn and 30 seconds back, and that usually brings me very well to the landing point. So that was around 9 group 5.
That looks controllable, and that just happened on the way up.
Oh crap!
A couple of years ago I did a time when that happened to me from a mid-air collision some 200 meters up. He has it under control, so with good enough thermal I'm sure he can make the full time. It looks like he decided to land.
Stay close to me.